please let us all enjoy what he has to tell us. Also with the sellings, if you have to sell, talk, whisper. So be quiet, please. Thank you.
Okay. Woo.
This is fantastic. I'm very proud to be here, I must say. And does everybody know who I am?
Yes!
Do you know what I did on ABBA? Do you know how many tracks I play on?
46.
Yeah, that was one, yeah. You know. I'm so proud to be here. And it's a very strange feeling for me to be here 50 years later. And I'm going to tell you a little, I'm going to start to tell you when I was working in the 60s. I was working with some pop groups. And I was working, playing with a group called Sleepstones. Playing around in Sweden, we played a little bit in Copenhagen also. And then at the same time when I was touring with the pop group in Sweden, there was another pop group called Hep Stars. You familiar with Hep Stars?
Yes.
Yeah. And there was another group, also more like, not pop group, but singing Hootenanny. There were Hootenanny singers. Do you know that?
Yes.
Yeah. And also there was a girl in from Jönköping. When I started as a session musician in 1970, I recorded with her. Her name was Agneta Fetzko. She was very popular in Sweden. And also I met 1968, I played with a Swedish singer and I played in Eskilstuna Fortis Park. And he said that his name was Gunnar Wiklund and he said, "Now, Janne, you have to meet a very nice young girl. She's a singer. She's a very good singer." That was Anne-Frid Lindström. So I met all those guys that we're going to talk about in the 60s, actually. In 1970, I started beginning to record with other artists as a session musician. The first one was Björn Skifs, also called the Blues Swede. And then I was sitting recording, and 1971, I was sitting in the Swedish Eurovision Song Contest Orchestra and playing with a lot of Swedish artists, and I was recording. And also, I had been introduced by a guy from Africa, Reba Kwakuba. He asked me, "Janne, do you want to play on a session with a film score music?" Yes, I said, "Yeah, that's nice. What kind of movie is that?" "Yeah, it's coming, a guy from America. He's a soul singer called Johnny Nash. And he's going to write the music and he's going to act as one of the actors in the movie. And the movie is called Want So Much to Believe." And we started recording the score music, and then after a while I noticed we were doing so many hours, so many sessions. I thought, this guy is withdrawing. He want us to do some demos for his forthcoming album. And suddenly one day they were living in a house in Stockholm, and they said, "Janne, could you come to the house? I'm going to show you some new music for my new album." "Oh, nice. I said, "Yeah." And I went to the house and they played me a record and said, "What do you think about this?" And that was not the best thing I've heard in my life, but I said, "It sounds very interesting, Janne. Yeah, we're going to bring this guy here, we're going to teach you how to play this new music, Janne." And that was, 1971 was the start, and this was a totally new thing. And they said, "We're going to bring this guy here, we're going to teach you how to play this new music." And after a couple of days, he came to Stockholm. And but the house they stayed in was crowded with people, because the Americans, the musicians, had met Swedish girlfriends. And they said, "Why are we going to put this guy? We put him in the cellar. "Yeah, that's a good idea." And then he stayed, and he said, seller in a house in Nockeby in Stockholm, and the guy was Bob Marley. And to show someone, sometimes they think this is just a special story or something. This is not true. Yes, it is. So that's why I'm going to show you a little piece where Bob Marley is sitting in the cellar in Stockholm, 1971, and I had a lesson in reggae music. Listen to this. You will hear a very famous song for the first time from the cellar. Yes. It's coming very soon.
Let's do it up.
Can a little louder. Yes. It's coming.
I can't hear it.
He was very shy. But not that this shy, I think. But this is how he looked when I met him. I think we are we is okay? Something will, is that a problem? Okay, we should I go on or do we have
great book?
Thank you.
Little darling, still love.
Yes. Every night.
Little darling, still love. Little darling, it's been a long, long time since I've got you on my mind. Oh, now you are here, it's so clear to see what we could do, just you and me. Yeah, let's tear it up. Little darling, tear it up. Oh, come on, woman. Little darling, come on, tear it up.
So that's the first time I met this music, and I got very impressed by it. And in the studio, together with Bob Marley and Johnny Nash, was also a drummer, which I have known since the ending of '60s. And we recorded the basic track for the movie and with Johnny Nash. And now we're going on very quickly, so now we can take this next song, and then we'll hear Ola Brokett on drums, me on guitar, and this is more reggae thing, how we played it. Okay.
Deeper down.
time we heard this music and played the reggae music, which we got one of the musicians was John Rabbit Bundrick, and he will turn up later on the track of ABBA. And that was very, it was very interesting to learn this kind of music. And Bob Marley told me, Janne, take it, lay back, don't push it, Janne, take it easy, take it easy. Around the same time, there was a guy in Sweden called Stikkan Andersson. I think you're all familiar with him. He had started the Swedish record Polar. And I was recording a lot for Polar. I recorded Lena Andersson, Anders Bugelstad, and also Big Bam, and Gugge Hedrenius' Big Bam. And that, when the producer of that Big Bam album was Benny Andersson. Stikkan had hired Björn and Benny as producers to look for young kids to record for the Polar record. And one day, is what also the same year as I recorded with Bob Marley and Johnny Nash, I got a phone call from Benny, I think. He said, Janne, could you come to our office? We have found a young cat. He's so good. Could you come here and listen? I went there to the Jungfrugatan 18 in Östermalm in Stockholm, two stairs up, and there was the young guy. His name was Ted Gärdestad. He was sitting playing acoustic guitar. Björn Ulvaeus told me just a couple of years ago, they had got so many cassettes from young artists, and there was two of them who was really special. One was a guy called Harpo, and the other one was Ted Gärdestad. And they said, we can't do two guys. We call Bengt Palmers, he will take care of Harpo, we take care of Ted Gärdestad. And I was now sitting in the office, listening to Ted. He was playing a left-handed acoustic guitar and singing his songs. And that music went right into my heart. It was fantastic music. I listened to it, and Benny asked me, what do you think about this, Janne? I think, oh, this is fantastic, Benny. If you like it, you're going to record with him. Yeah, we do that. Do you know a drummer? Yeah, I know a drummer, Ola Brunken. Yeah, that's good. And the bass player, Mike Watson. Okay, and then we booked the Metronome studio, and that was the guy who worked as an engineer there, was Michael B. Tretto. And we started recording Teddy Adelstock's first album, and when he had done some, he was fantastic. I mean, Teddy Adelstock was, we became very close friends. And when he had made some, his overdubs, they said, we must have a choir. Who shall we call? We called the girls. That was Agneta Petskov and Anna-Frid Lundstad. And I want to play you a short tune from Teddy Adelstad's first album, where you can hear the background vocals after a while. In the second chorus, you will hear Anna-Frid and Agneta in the choir, and you will hear a touch of what later would become the very famous group. Listen to Teddy Adelstad.
Lyckas bli föräldrafri.
slightly what will become later on. We had recorded his Teddy Anderson's first album, which was a totally big, huge success in Sweden. He was a young cat, looking very good. He was very happy. He wrote such good songs. And Björn and Benny was producing the album, and Anna-Frid Agneta was in the choir. So before Ted Gärdestad's first album was released, actually, we were all called up. It was me, Ola Brunke, Mike Watson, and Michael B. Tretow, and Björn and Benny said, we have written a tune of our own. Do you want to play on it? Yeah, because we were, Ted Gärdestad's first album, we were getting very close together. Everything was functioning very easily, and Ola was playing such a good drums, and Mike Watson was a good player. So, and then they said, "We have written a new tune. What do you want to play?" Yeah, and that tune we're going to listen to right now.
People need hope. People need loving. People need trust from a fellow man.
To Teddy, I could play a lot of Teddy Anderson tune, but since we're now working on ABBA 50 years, I would like to play a little more songs. And these are all the songs that I played on with ABBA. And since you know, this was the group wasn't named ABBA this time. And I told you, Agneta was a very big star in Sweden. She was maybe the most famous of the four of them. So she actually wrote one tune. And it's a little similar to your Childhood tune I play a little by. I think we can listen to this. This is the only track that I know. Maybe somebody else have some other idea that Agneta wrote for ABBA. Listen to this. During a little later on in the 70s, where she re-recorded this tune and sang it in Swedish. And when you listen to this, how it sounds like, we all play live in the studio. We made the backing track first without the vocals, and then they put the vocals on. And now I'm gonna play another tune where I put on a couple of guitar licks. There were no arrangements when we recorded, so do you know some guitar licks? Yeah, but try this, and I tried this, and now you will hear Love Isn't Easy. Listen to this.
Thank you. should go. Just give it some more time and you'll see our love will grow. Darling, I know we gotta have patience. Love is just a sensation. Some of the time it gets rough. Love isn't easy, but it sure is hard enough. Sweet, sweet, our love is bittersweet.
This is really good. Maybe we had not re-recorded it now, it would have been a very huge success, I think. But and you hear that Björn Ulvaeus is still having the lead vocals, but when the choir comes in, you hear slightly the Agneta Frida's voices are very, very strong. But next tune I'm going to play also at the Björn Benio. Do you have some licks on the for the introduction? Yeah, we try that. This little country influences, and that this one was the second single from ABBA. This is what. And you will hear still, I was like, they wanted me to play a lot of guitar licks on this one and those tracks. And I like that very much. It was so fun. We had so much fun when we recorded with ABBA. And suddenly they wanted to have it more rock. When we had, at this time, Deep Purple was doing the first album. We had listened a little bit to Deep Purple and Björn wanted to sing a little rock and roll, so let's go for a rock and roll band. Watch out, play the introduction to. Yeah. Wasn't the right sound. I mean, it's very good recording, very good songs, and I love to play with ABBA because I had a lot of guitar work to do. But then they said they had listened to a guy in America called Phil Spector. How can we make that big sound? And Michael Vietrinto said, let's, when you play the basic track and do it overdub, and play exactly the same thing, and I changed the speed on the tape recorder a little bit. And we tried to, and we did that. And the result of that was the song that we recorded in 1973. Listen to this. Also, that year I was in the Swedish Melody Orchestra in Sweden playing live, and they came number 3, and they were very disappointed. Jenny Starbo was also in the competition that year. He came number five or something like that. And that year, 1973, I recorded my own first album, solo album, which is an instrumental one. And what happened with my album? I went number one, 6 weeks. I sold more than ABBA and Teddy and so. That will never ever happen again in the world. But if you're interested, I will sit there and sell you. I have a couple of vinyls with me, and I have some other records on the CDs and boxes, and you can, if you're interested, I have it, so I can sign it as well. But what happened then? Yeah, they were very disappointed, 1973, but they said, let's go on recording again. And then we worked on a tune, and all the time we recorded with ABBA, they had no titles, no vocals, no lyrics, anything. And we worked on a tune, and then they said, we need to have a line in the refrain, like we have in Ring Ring. Do, 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 do. If somebody has, I said, what do you think about this? This tune goes in D, and tune down the low E string to D, and this. That's a good idea. And we recorded it exactly the same way as we recorded Ring Ring. And they asked me also, do you know a saxophone player that plays a little rock and roll? I said, I know a guy called Christer Eklund. I play with him. He plays like King Kurt. Yeah, they call him in, man. Christer Eklund was doing the saxophone. And the result is this tune, which you know very well. Listen to this.
It's all we repeat in the sand. Waterloo, I was defeated in the Wonder War. Waterloo, I want to love you forevermore. Waterloo, couldn't escape me if I wanted to. Waterloo.
And notice the bass playing is fantastic. Rutger, it was a fantastic, extremely good bass player. And I asked him, where do you come from? I'm educated in classical guitar in the Swedish Music High School, but I can't get no job on the classical guitar. So then I went over to bass. But ABBA wanted to still go on rock and roll, so they made a rock tune and said, Janne, do you have some idea and introduction? Yeah, well, try this. And it sounds like this, Key Kong song. Eurovision Song Contest was in Sweden. We have recorded a lot of tracks, and I got a phone call from Björn Benny, so asked me, we are planning to choose one of the tunes we recorded. And I said, what do you think, Janne? Waterloo. I said, Waterloo is absolutely the best. But the other tune they were thinking maybe they should have in the competition is this one. And it's a very good tune, but it would have been the same effect as Waterloo. This is a very good tune. Hasta mañana.
as well as all the other tracks I'm playing now. And this one, I often get asked, but is there no guitar solos? There were no guitar solos except for some introduction and some fills, but there is one tune that I have a guitar solo, and it comes after a while. But I must also say, the bass playing on this track is extremely good, and that's Rutger Gunnarsson as well. My mama said. During my yes, please. Thank you. Roland, I think we can jump to the next one. So we go to the next one, which is Watch Out. And that's when I'm going to play you Watch Out, because that was the first time I used a guitar synthesizer on an ABBA track. And I found it, and we were always experimenting, and Michael Beatriz was very into get some new sounds, and I did some introduction on Watch Out, which is on a octave guitar synthesizer. We play that, Watch Out. Together with Benny, guitar and synthesizer, or this electric piano, I don't remember. I think it's a very beautiful tune, and Frida is singing the lead when he's singing my love song. Mm-hmm. we just come in half of it, but we come back when will I come back?
I don't know by head, but you have a second part, so there will be a second part like this. Yeah.
Called The Meters, and you will hear it in the rhythm section. I like this tune. Yeah, very good. Thank you.
Did you see that man in the little sea?
Song, and this is also a very nice song, I think. Banging Boomerang. Benny said, "Janne, could you overdub what they're playing in on the basic track from in the States? Because we want to have the Swedish ABBA sound back." And I put the overdub over this very, very famous guitar lick in the beginning of this tune. You will recognize it. Okay. Album I play on, I had a pedal called Morley pedal where I could, when I put the pedal down, I could get a very strange sound, and it's a sort of echo. So I tried in the beginning, when I put it down, it goes up, a very strange sound. And we had made a basic backing track, and I was playing around with that, and Michael Beatrick said, "Oh, Janne, we have to put this in the front on, in the beginning of this tune. It will be fantastic." And then also we recorded this one in the Glenmark studio, and Bruno Glenmark had a swimming pool, and we put out all the Marshall amps, and I was playing as loud as possible. The only thing was that in that house, Bruno Glenmark lived with his wife Anne-Louise, and Anne-Louise's mother was at home, and she saw she thought it was an earthquake going up. But you will listen to this tune. It's a very good tune. I think you have, you know it, everybody. But listen to the beginning of the pedal when I put it down, and you will hear that make the sound in the beginning. Okay, that's it. We recorded in the Polar studio. It was close to St. Erik's Plan in Stockholm. And on this tune, we had listened a little bit to the Bee Gees. And I played on a Fender guitar, Fender Telecaster guitar, to have a guitar lick. And this one. And I'm
ABBA wanted still doing some rock music, and this one I play a little guitar on as well, and it's Björn singing the lead vocals. Rock me. Very good. The next tune I'm gonna play for you, I don't use my ordinary guitar, because I have a so-called sitar guitar at home. It sounds little like sitar, but it's not a sitar. But you can play it as an ordinary guitar. And Björn and Benny had already made a background, and Benny called me and said, could you put on, play the same thing as I do on the synthesizer on this one? This is also a very famous tune. Okay. We didn't do it because they had the basic tracks along, and they made, because they are always it's no live recording, it's always playback. So to do playback in London, we had to re-record it in London, but we didn't do that. But I like this tune very, very much. It's a disco tune. It's playing. Over this one, and I don't know how much to see it. Play it.
Yeah.
Matthias borrowed the title from Martin Luther King, actually, because he said that in a very famous speech in America. I play on so many tracks, I don't play them all, but this one, I have no memory of playing on this part, but I know I do, Angel Eyes. To record an album in Hollywood, and I was very honored to do that. So I said yes, nice, and I brought my best friend Dioniso Lindelof, and they asked me, "What do you want to which drummer do you want? I said, I don't know the drummers, but I had an album at home with a guitar player from, his name is Les Dudek, played with all my brother's band. And I said, told them, this drummer is very, very good. What's his name? Oh, it's Jeff Porcaro. Oh, Jeff Porcaro, that's a very, he's very famous in Hollywood, yeah. We came over, me and Björn Isolin, and we had no bass player, so I said to Jeff Porcaro, do you know a bass player? Yeah, you can talk, you can have my brother, Mike Porcaro. Okay, that's good. We need a percussionist. We can take my father, Joe Porcaro. And I also play with Steve Porcaro. And those guys, they are also session musicians in America. They were session, because it's just Steve living now. And what did they play with? Yeah, they played with Michael Jackson, the Springs. They played on everything, the Quincy Jones, and a lot of things. And I'm very, very proud that I made an album with those guys. And, we recorded and they were, we came very, very well together. And then Jeff Porcaro said, yeah, come, we started a band of our own. Okay, well, nice, huh? Come and listen to a track. And we went to a studio and Jeff Porcaro played us a tune. And he said, this was just the backing track. And that track was called Hold the Line. And he said, we are very impressed by a European band. Yeah, which one is that? They're called ABBA. Oh, it's very clever to have four letters and two of them are the same. ABBA. Everybody will remember that. That's why we call ourselves Toto. I just play one song. It's a totally different music. But I'm very proud to play with Jeff, Mike, Steve, and therefore Joe Porcaro. And this is a very quick one, and just instrumental. And this is my last tune on this lecture. And I'm very happy that you listen to me. And I'm going to sit there and write some autograph if you want to. But now it is 4 days in summer night.
Signing more over there, and we will continue with a little things from Voyage, and we will be back here, I don't remember exactly, but very shortly for the quiz winners. Yay. Thank you, Shana Shafra.